it's a matter of the heart as to whether we serve God with our whole hearts or whether we allow the calluses to take over. Some of us got a heart transplant the last time I was here, and some of us are still going through that. The onion is being peeled because God is healing us so that we can be all that God called us to be. Who wants to live in those old cycles of depression and the same old friends? If you're living in the same old cycles and you're staying in that same place and your life never changes and the things never change, yet you call yourself a Christian, then there are things in your heart that you have not released to God or not acknowledged or are in denial about or are not dealing with because you are fearful of dealing with them or don't want to go there. But until you do, you cannot grow. Until you do, you cannot change. Until you do, you won't find the fullness and the glory of God that wants to be poured out on you, because you'll be holding and withholding, amen, withholding in your heart without realizing it. But God wants you to open your heart completely to the Lord. Open the eyes of your heart, open your heart, so that not only can you receive, but that whatever God plants in there will be sustained. So the character that God looks for in people is a heart that is aligned with the heart of God. Why? Because you'll remember that the one thing God looked for and said that this is the characteristic I'm looking for in a leader is to have a person that has a heart after God's own heart. And who was that? Remember, that was David. Why was he selected? He didn't look the part. He was younger than all his brothers. He was selected because of his heart. God knew that he had a heart that searched after and that desired the will of God more than anything else. So sometimes you may not think God's forgiven you because the consequences of your decisions and your actions might still be evident in your life. But you can't blame God, because God hasn't just miraculously, supernaturally turned around things that you did. But you've got to give God time to do that if you stay in alignment. Amen. Love is not conditional with God. God's love is unconditional. And when we truly let that unconditional love penetrate our hearts, that unconditional love begins to saturate every part of us. And it becomes part of who we are. In other words, we become like Christ. But when we only see God's love conditionally, we become conditional with our love. We become conditional with what we give. I'm talking about of ourselves. We become conditional in every aspect of our lives. And God's love is not that. And that's what creates a bad attitude. And the first point I gave you was that the condition of our heart determines our attitude last week. Because scripture teaches us that the Lord searches the heart and the heart determines the attitude, right? You've heard people say they've got a bad attitude. Anybody heard that? What makes you think so? They may not have said a word to you. They could have just walked past you in a certain demeanor. They could have just huffed and puffed like this. A person doesn't have to say a thing, but they can show a bad attitude through their actions. So you have to be careful of your attitude. You have to be careful of what you show. What manifests from your life? What manifests from your life is determined by what is in your heart. So the attitude that manifests from your life is determined from your heart. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. Now listen carefully, underline this in your Bibles. It judges the thoughts and attitudes of the heart. Isn't that powerful? Point number two, the condition of our heart determines our priorities. I just want to read you though Psalm 40, and particularly verse 8. Here is what the psalmist said. I desire to do your will, O my God. Your law is within my heart. Now this is Old Testament. Your law is within my heart. We want to become those that so desire after God that nothing else matters to us than following God. That our will is totally aligned with God. When your will, when your heart is totally aligned with God and your spirit is aligned with God, it's so difficult for the enemy to get in. It's almost impossible, because it's that area of the soul that he goes into and the only place that he has access. Amen? So you ask yourself when you go back now to Matthew 6:21, which says,
where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. There it is.
Where your treasure is, say it with me, where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. So whatever you value the most, whatever you spend the most time on, that's where your heart really is. You can't tell God anything else. You can't tell anyone anything else. Where you spend the most time and what you give the most priority to and what you give the first priority to will be where your heart really is. That's it. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also.